Yo, what's up, everybody? It is Friday, May 17th. Dow 40,000. We got to close over 40,000 today. NASDAQ was down a little bit, S&P was up a little bit. Look, there's a lot of momentum in this market. I was saying that we're still going to have very strong fiscal flows going into June 1st, maybe even a few days after June 1st. We got the June 1st, first of the month payments. That's big. We just had the quarterly interest payment. We had a Social Security payment. We get another Social Security payment next Wednesday. So the flows are very, very strong. You got a lot of momentum. And like I said yesterday, you got a lot of people now jumping into this market, and these are people who, you know, they were out of the market all last year, or they were short, very bearish, very negative. The AAII sentiment survey for this week, it ended up with very low levels of bearish sentiment. Bullish sentiment was elevated, not extreme, but low levels of bearish sentiment and pretty high level of neutrals. So it looked like the bears jumped into the neutral column. They didn't go into the bullish column in any big way. They shifted to neutral. So take that for however you want to read it. I see it as, low levels of bearish sentiment. It's just, it all kind of fits into my bigger picture outlook of like, you know, I'm just not a fan of this rally, as I've been saying. Now, one thing I want to mention here, and something I don't ordinarily talk about, but if you look at the PE ratio of the S&P 500 right now, all right, if you use that as some kind of a valuation measure, and I do. I do use that when it comes to individual stocks, but I use the inverse of the PE ratio is what's called the earnings yield. Like, how much return are you getting from actual corporate earnings? Because ostensibly, that's why you invest in stocks. That's why you buy little pieces of a company, is to participate in that earnings stream over time. So the PE ratio of the S&P 500 right now is 25. That's high. And the inverse of that, if you take 1 divided by 25, that comes out to a 4% earnings yield. 4%. But if you think about it, the risk-free rate on cash right now is 5.5%. Right? If you get like a 90-day, a 30-day, 90-day T-bill, 5.5%. Risk-free, what do you need to be in stocks at 4% earnings yield? Now, maybe you argue, yeah, Mike, but the market is going up, so you have capital appreciation, but there's no guarantee of that, like in the short term. Over time, I would say yes. But so, and that's, I'm not saying you should use that solely as a deciding factor. I'm not saying that. I'm just pointing it out that, you know, I'm seeing things now, again, that just doesn't make me a fan of this rally and makes me cautious. You got a 4% earnings yield on the S&P 500. You have $176 billion drop in net government transfers this year compared to last year. That's a shrinking in the AKA deficit. All right. You got a lot of people. I said yesterday, I don't like the cohort that is getting involved in the stock market right now. These are people who, like I just said earlier, they were out or they were short the market last year, and they were all screaming, you know, recession and market crash and blah, blah, blah. I was the guy telling you here, you know, economy's going to be fine. Market's going to make new all-time highs. I was telling you all that stuff. So I don't like the cohort going into the market right now. I don't think the market valuation is very attractive. I'm generally fully invested. It's the way I've always said, like, I like to buy good assets and accumulate them over time and just build that and build that and build that. That's how you grow your wealth, okay? And I've said many times, the stock market is the greatest wealth creating mechanism that there ever was. So that's how I approach it. But, you know, there's times when I like to rotate out and have, so that provides some cash on the side for when we get better buying opportunities. It's like I said, if you use like a retail shopping example, and I have my eye on my favorite items, whatever those might be, okay? And the stores are jacking up the prices of my favorite items. I don't run in there to buy the items. I wait till they're on sale. And while they may never be on sale in an actual retail store or retail environment, the stock market always runs sales. Always. Okay? It's just a matter of you waiting for the sales. And I know a lot of people can't do that. And they get very emotional when they see the market going up. And they get into this kind of FOMO mentality, the fear of missing out. And they run after it. You know, I talk to a lot of people. And when I say my preferred vehicle is the stock market, they say, oh, but you could lose money. I don't think I ever lost money. I lost money back in the days of my trading days, and that was, but that was not mostly stocks. It was mostly commodities and futures. But that reaction, oh, you could lose money. Yeah, when you invest stupidly and emotionally and lacking discipline, but that saying applies to anything when you act emotionally and without discipline and just like willy-nilly like that. So I wait for it to go on sale, and then I go in and I buy my favorite items, which is the stocks that I accumulate over time. What stocks are those? Very simply, and I've said this in the past, I like to own the major companies in their industry, who are the leaders in their industry, who have a long history of profitability, and hopefully the ones that pay dividends. They don't all pay dividends, like there's a lot in the tech sector that don't pay dividends, but they're definitely not only leaders in their industry, they're high growth enterprises, okay? So that's the other thing, like you could justify a 25 PE on the S&P 500 if we are in a high growth economic environment. Okay, same thing like with a stock. A stock might have a high PE, like a stock like Nvidia or something like that, but it's in a high growth environment, okay? Artificial intelligence or something of that nature. But the economy is slow. We saw the slowdown in the first quarter. It dropped from 3.2% in the fourth quarter of 2023 to 1.6%. And by the way, I mentioned that yesterday in my video, I said that the Atlanta Fed had their GDP now at 4.2% forecast for the second quarter. And I was like, I have no idea how they came up with that. But they did revise it down now to 3.6%. So it's going in my direction. You know, I don't know if it's going to keep going that way, maybe go back up, but it's going in my direction. And I said that was going to happen. I said, if my analysis is correct, and if the numbers I'm seeing are correct, which the numbers are correct, it's just, is my analysis correct? That 4.2, I said that GDP now forecast is going to come down, and it is starting to come down. Not a lot, but it came down like already like 0.6%. So we'll see. But anyway, again, I'm just going to repeat, I'm not a fan of this rally. I want to mention also, I should mention gold and silver, really gold new highs today. Silver really took off, man. big day, almost a $2 day in silver, huge. I just looked at the CFTC Commitments of Traders report, but that was for the week ending Tuesday, which, what was Tuesday? Today's the 17th, 16th, 15th, the 14th. Okay, that was for the week ending May 14th. And producers were selling silver. They were net sellers of silver futures. Gold producers were buying gold. So take that for what it's worth. I do a whole write-up on this in the MMT Trader Report, which goes out. I've been sending it out on Sunday. If you want to get a copy of that, go to my website, pitbulleconomics.com. Sign up for a 30-day free trial of MMT Trader. If economic growth slows down, I'll tell you this, that the gold and silver rallies will not hold. It's not that I'm bearish overall on gold and silver. I'm not. But I'm just telling you that if economic growth is slowing down, the rallies won't hold. And this jump that we just saw, that's another one of these things, these FOMO things, fear of missing out, people jumping in. And like I said, silver producers were selling last week. I don't know what they did at the end of the week, but they were selling up through last Tuesday. Anyway, that's it for now. Please like and subscribe if you choose to. And again, don't forget to go to my website, pitbulleconomics.com. Sign up for a 30-day free trial of MMT Trader. I teach the concepts and understandings of MMT. And I show you how to use that to trade and invest profitably in the financial markets. Have a nice weekend. Bye.